If you are integrating your SmartSuite with a third-party tool, there's a really good chance that you are using Make in order to leverage that automation. Well, in this video, I'm going to be breaking down for you exactly how to build the best triggers to trigger automations in Make. You might have noticed that the Make and SmartSuite integration doesn't quite have all the triggers you might want, but with this handy little workaround that I'll demonstrate here, you will get exactly the results you need in about half the steps. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Hey, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you to get organized and automated with no-code tools. And SmartSuite is one of my favorite no-code tools, and I'm excited to be sharing with you these automation tricks inside of this video. But before we get into it, if you're an automation enthusiast, you are going to love my free training that is going to teach you the basic building blocks of no-code automation. Grab that training, absolutely free, gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. Once you enter your email address there, you will get immediate access. Training's about an hour long. Watch it whenever you'd like. But the benefit for you is that you will learn the key fundamentals of building automations inside of no-code platforms just like this. It doesn't matter what software you're using, no-code automation comes together in similar ways, and that's what we're going to cover in that training. But without further ado, let's go ahead and hop on into my screen and start talking about our specific use case here. And the specific use case that we're looking at is how to build an ideal trigger for something that's happening in SmartSuite, but to build this trigger in Make so that we can integrate with third-party tools. Let's say, for example, you want to create an invoice in QuickBooks. Well, we can't do that inside of SmartSuite's native automation tool. We have to use a third-party tool, like Make, in order to get this done. But if I were to flip into Make, here I have a new scenario. And if you're looking for a specific SmartSuite type of trigger, we can go in, look at SmartSuite, and we see the two different trigger types. We have watch new records and watch updated records. So new records is, hey, a new record was created in SmartSuite, probably through a form or maybe through some other automation. And we can use that as a trigger, but that's not going to meet our needs here. Now we can also watch updated records. So we can set up something that says, anytime a record in this particular application is updated, trigger the automation. But imagine how many times we're going to burn through operations here in Make if we use this kind of trigger. Imagine every little change you make into a SmartSuite record is going to trigger your automation. And then you have to apply a filter that says, well, under certain conditions, only if this is the record that was changed, or only if this particular status was updated, only under conditions do I want you to move forward. And so yes, your automation won't move forward because you've built these fancy filters, but you're still burning through all of your Make operations. You're still triggering the automation off of every single updated record, and that's going to burn through your tasks unnecessarily and cause you to run up a high bill with Make. We want to avoid this, so let's build a better trigger. Here is exactly how you do it. Let's pop into SmartSuite and look at an example. Here I have this application called Subtasks. And for my specific example, I want to trigger my automation based on when the status of a subtask is marked complete. Now I've chosen this completely arbitrarily. Whatever conditions you want to specify, those are the conditions under which you want to trigger your automation. So for me, it's marking this to be complete. For you, it could be whatever unique conditions you've established for your specific records. So first step is to build an automation inside of SmartSuite based on these conditions. It's a very simple automation that will not require any code whatsoever. Once we are set up with that automation, the second step will be to send information to Make from that first automation, and this will all be built without a single line of code, and you'll see how quickly and easily these two pieces come together. So first, I need to establish my automation inside of SmartSuite. I go up to the top of my solution, and I click on Automations. I'm going to add a new automation here, and the first thing I'm asked to do is establish the trigger for the automation. You'll notice that inside of SmartSuite's native automation, we have a lot more options for triggering our automations. So we have webhook received, but this is coming soon. We don't have access yet. What I want is record meeting very specific conditions. Then and only then do I want to trigger my automation. So I set this up right here, record matches conditions. Now here I can choose whatever conditions those are. For me, it's gonna be subtasks. And I'll set up to say the subtasks, the status field, is equal to complete. Notice that I have a lot of control here. I could say is not equal to, has any of. I could establish other conditions here and stack additional conditions using and, or alternatively I can use or conditional logic inside of my trigger. Now for me, it's gonna be fairly simple. Status equal to complete. That's all I wanna do. And in my next step, I'm going to send information to make to start the other second automation. So let's get into make so that we know what we're gonna be doing there. So simply, once inside of make, search for the webhook application. Once we're here, you'll see that I have the option of a custom webhook or a custom mailhook. Custom mailhook is very much like a webhook, except that the place that we're sending the information to is actually an email. So we're gonna pick custom mailhook. You'll notice that this is an instant trigger. I can add a new hook here. So I'll call this one test number one and save it up. And the output that make gives me is actually an email address. So I'm gonna copy this email address, and now I'm gonna flip back into SmartSuite and I'm gonna set up my action. Remember, this SmartSuite automation is gonna trigger when my conditions are met. And then I'm going to send an email. I'm going to send an email using SmartSuite's native email automation tool. I'm going to send it to the mailhook address that I just got from make. So I'm just pasting in the address right here. Now in the subject of this, I want to include the record ID. Now inside of my fields, if I perform a search, you'll see that I've actually created two fields for my record ID. Now only one of these is actually going to help me in this particular example. What I need is to bring in the unique record ID and send it over to make. Now, if you're building this yourself, I would recommend that you use a formula in order to display your record ID. You're gonna see why in just a minute. This right here is a similar field, but instead of using the formula, instead here we have an actual record ID field type. They have the exact same output, but the way that make interacts with SmartSuite is going to be different based on the type of field you've created. So again, my recommendation is to go forward with the formula, call it record ID or whatever you prefer, and simply have it display the record ID. So again, here I'm gonna paste that in right here into my subject. The message does not matter at all. We do have to have a message as a requirement of the automation. This is a required field. Doesn't matter what we're sending here. Make sure in your subject you don't have any trailing spaces or anything else. All we want to send through in the subject is the record ID. Once we're happy with this, we can rename our automation. And this will be send mailhook to make. And of course, we are going to say add automation and we're going to switch it on. Now let's head back into make and do a little bit of a test. So over here, we know that we've built an automation that when specific conditions are met inside of SmartSuite, we're gonna send this mailhook over to make. That is going to then trigger our second make automation. So back into make, let's go back here, click okay, and I'm gonna right click and run this module only. You see it's looking right now, it's waiting to receive a message. I'm flipping back into SmartSuite and I'm going to mark one of these things as complete. That will in turn initiate our SmartSuite automation right here, send mailhook to make. Flipping over into make, we can now see that we received that mailhook. So we can look at the payload that we received, and here is what came over when we sent that email to this specific address. It was simply this subject right here with an empty body to the email. And the important thing is, because we passed the record ID in the subject and nothing else, we can now use that in the next step of our automation. So let's go back really quickly into SmartSuite and take another look here. I have two different fields where I'm calling up the record ID. Remember, one of these is an ID field type. The other one is a formula field type where I'm calling in the record ID. I recommend the latter and you're gonna see why right now. So back inside of make, now that our automation is triggered, we now need to find the record that initiated the automation so that we can receive all the other information about that record. So now I'm going to, as my second step, connect to SmartSuite. Let's go ahead and find it from the list here. And I'm going to get a record. Notice that this is telling me that I'm going to get a SmartSuite record by a field match or through a SmartSuite search syntax. Let's go ahead and follow the steps here. I set up my connection and I find my solution. Mine is called complicated formulas. So let's go ahead and find that solution here. And now I have to tell it what application I'm looking at. In my case, it's the subtasks application. Now remember, I have the record ID in the subject line of the mail hook. And so I am going to map out a certain field. What field am I looking for? Well, if you recall, I have two different record ID fields, but only one of them shows up here, the one called rec ID. Flipping back into SmartSuite, record ID, because of the field type that it is, this record ID field type, does not show up inside of make when I am searching under that ID. However, the formula rec ID does. And so this is why I recommend using the formula. And if I were to search again, you see that I don't have record ID as an option, only rec ID, which is my formula field type. Now, what is the search value? So I'm looking in the rec ID field to find a match for the subject that came over in the mail hook. So let's go ahead and run this particular module. Let's first copy the subject here. This is the record ID from the record that initiated the automation. So I'm just going to copy and then right click here and run the second module. And I can paste in the record ID from our first example. And let's take a look. Here is what we receive from make. Everything about that record. So as you can see, what we've built here in just a few steps, although it takes a little bit to explain, two different automations working together to allow us to trigger inside of make. The first automation is going to say, under certain conditions inside of SmartSuite, then I'm going to send this information to an email mailhook. And then the second automation is initiated when the email is received at that mailhook. And then and only then do we go back into SmartSuite, find the record in question, and now we can do whatever we want to do. Integrate with QuickBooks, send a message through Slack, create an invoice in Stripe. The sky's the limit. All the other tools that Make is already integrated with, we can now build and integrate into our automation. I know we went kind of fast in this video. There is a lot to cover, but I hope you got a ton of value from it. If you have questions, be sure to drop them below. And in the meantime, keep on building.